This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. Today we're going to look at a common, but oftentimes not correctly identified tree native here in Indiana. Now some of you are going to be looking at this and saying, yeah, it's common and we know what it is. This is sugar maple. Well, this is actually black maple. Black maple looks an awfully lot like sugar maple, but there are a couple of different characteristics that will help us identify this tree from its close cousin sugar maple. First off, black maple will have a tendency to have these little stipules. It's like a little miniature leaf at the base of the large leaves. This is a common characteristic that's held on oftentimes through the summer. And so look at the base of that leaf stem, and if you find that little stipule there, there's a good chance you're looking at black maple, not sugar maple. In sugar maple, these are absent. One of the other characteristics for black maple are mottled gray stems with dark buds. The stems on sugar maple have a tendency to be a medium to dark brown with dark brown buds as well. The bark on black maple is very similar to sugar maple. And we get a lot of variation in these bark patterns, but it's typically a lighter gray color and maybe relatively smooth like this in young trees with flakes or plates in older trees. One of the characteristics of black maple that shows up later in the growing season are large dark leaves that have a tendency to droop at the edges. And so as this tree matures through the summer, we'll typically see a darkening of the leaves, and these broad leaves will have a tendency to droop down at the edges as well. So using the characteristics of the stipules, that mottled gray stem color, and the dark buds, and the dark leaves that droop at the edges, maybe you can impress some of your friends by differentiating between sugar maple and black maple.